Most software that you buy on AppSumo was created by a third-party developer that listed it on the AppSumo marketplace so that people like you and I can buy it and use it in our business. But every once in a while, AppSumo themselves develops a software product from scratch. They've got an entire team for this. They call them AppSumo Originals. And when AppSumo reached out to me and told me, hey, we've got a brand new original, would you like to make a sponsored video for it for your channel? I jumped at the chance because I already use several of their originals in my everyday business, including Breeze Docs for contracts and TidyCal for booking appointments. In fact, I just ran a contest on this channel and I used a third AppSumo original called King Sumo. The contest ran smoothly. I really enjoyed the King Sumo experience and the winners have all been notified. So if you didn't hear from me, my condolences. Now today we are looking at their latest offering called FormRobin. And as the name implies, this will let you create forms so that people can contact you online. You can survey them, whatever you want to do with online forms. FormRobin is going to have you covered. Well, at least that's what they say. Let's go ahead and try this thing out. Now, the cool thing about FormRobin is that it does have AI baked in, so we should be able to give it a prompt and it will generate the form for us. I saw this first, I believe, with OpenForm, a previous AppSumo deal that I still use in my business to this day. Now, the cool thing about originals is they're always priced dirt cheap. There's nobody to split the fees with, so AppSumo can price it very low, which they do. $19 is going to give you lifetime access. There's no agency plan available yet. With some of their other tools, they've added in a second tier a few months or even a year down the line. They did that with both TidyCal as well as BreezeDoc. Those are still very reasonably priced. I think they're like $39 or $49. Very, very reasonable for additional users. But for this plan, we're just going to get a single user, three different workspaces, so you could use it for different environments, and you can generate up to 50 forms per month using AI. But if you know what you want to create and do it on your own, you do get unlimited forms. So here's the dashboard, and like most AppSumo originals, these are real meat and potato style products. You're not gonna see a ton of extra bells and whistles and options that overwhelm you. For me personally, I like that. I like purpose-built tools that do one thing and do it very well. Let's find out if FormRobin actually does that. So we'll go ahead and create our first form right here. You can see there's lots of buttons to create forms because I haven't done anything with this account yet. So I imagine I can click any button and it's gonna give me a similar experience. So I've got two options here. I can generate with AI or start from scratch. I'm going to go the start from scratch route first, and then we'll double back and see how the AI does. So first real downside to FormRobin is that when you start from scratch, you are literally starting from scratch. There's no templates, and I guess there doesn't need to be because if you want a template, you can just prompt AI to make one for you. But if you're used to the traditional platforms that have a wide range of different form templates for you to begin with, you won't find any of that here, but it is very easy to get going. You simply click the plus button here and add in a form field. So let's say I wanted to do an email address. I can give the field a name and some optional description text. There are some nice inline editing tools here, which is a little bit different, especially for something like a title field where you can choose to make it bold, italic, give it a background color, or even to strike through. Now you do have to select the text for it to apply. So I'm gonna select it all and you can see there, my email has a strike through. A little confusing, I don't recommend doing that, but it's interesting that they added that. I do notice there is a little glitch here with the CSS, maybe some JavaScript problems going on that when I hover over this, it kind of wiggles my whole screen. So just some tightening under the hood to do there. This is a new product, so not entirely shocking that there's a few bugs to work out. So now I can add a new field to my form by either hovering over the question to add one beforehand or going after the question to add it after. I could see this interface being slightly confusing to inexperienced users that might just think, well, how do I add another field? And they have to hover in just the right spot in order to get the plus symbol to show up. But for now, I'm gonna go ahead and just proceed here. We'll add in a phone number field, a short answer, a multiple choice answer, and a file upload. So no real issues building out a simple form here, just add in the questions that you want and it's pretty straightforward. But there is another feature that I wanna show you and it's called conditional logic, or as FormRobin calls it, conditional visibility. So essentially, if I only want certain questions to appear if someone gives a specific answer, I can do that. Most form builders call this conditional logic. Let me show you how it works. So let's say someone answered Wistia as their best AppSumo deal ever. Well, I want to ask them more about that purchase. So I can add a new question in here. And for this one, I'm going to make it a long answer. And I just said, what do you like most about Wistia? Now, I only want this question to appear when people check the Wistia box. Very easy to do inside of FormRobin. I just click on the conditional visibility. I set the question has to be best AppSumo deal ever is, and then I want to enter in Wistia. Then I can either show or hide this question. So as it's set up right now, people will only see this question if they answer Wistia as their answer up here. Now we do have some style options up here. There's a few different themes to choose from, actually quite a few themes. So if I wanted to go commerce pink, I can do that. Or maybe I want it random and AI is going to just pick a combination of colors for me. This is suspiciously like the AppSumo green. I wonder how random it truly is. Here's clean blue, and I'm gonna go back to random. It truly is random. All right, very cool. All right, we're gonna go ahead and preview what this actually looks like to the end user. I just wanna mention that it would be really cool if they had the option to save your own preset here, and I don't see that. So if you do have your own brand colors that you want to enter in, you will have to do that every time. So something to consider for future updates if the AppSumo team happens to see this video. I suppose the workaround for that right now would be to create a form and just use it as a template and then clone it on the front end. And we'll check to make sure that's possible here in a minute. But first, I'm gonna save and go ahead and preview this. All right, there we go. This looks very good, nice and clean. I like the larger typeface. That looks really good, very readable. Looks like I didn't give this one a title. It still says new form at the top. So let me see if I can fix that. We're gonna go back out here. And there's an invisible field here at the very top of the form. And I assume if you don't write anything in here, it's going to replace it with new form. So I'll just say, this is my contact form. There we go. This is my contact form. Let's go ahead and save this and we'll open it up in the preview. Sure enough, there it is. I'd love to see an option to just turn that off because sometimes you might not want to have a title. I bet you could override that by putting a space in and then previewing it. Yeah, that'll do it. So some little hacks, some little workarounds here to get things to look the way you want. Now notice there is some branding here, and that is something the AppSumo originals typically have. Often they will add in a higher tier to start to reduce or completely eliminate the branding. But as of right now, there's no way to turn that off. We can, however, turn this into more of a type form type experience by going to settings and turn on multi-page mode. And if we toggle this on, one question will be shown at a time with navigation buttons. So let's see what that looks like. Here we are. I can go ahead and just quickly enter in my phone number here. I'm navigating with the keyboard almost entirely here. I don't think the back arrow key works, so I have to actually click to go backwards, but I can hit return to move forward. All right, that was nice and clean and simple. I'm not totally loving the style that I've got going, so I'm gonna choose another template here. I'll go with the default, and then I'm just gonna change the secondary color, which is the button color, to something red. I just feel like red buttons always work. All right, there we go. That looks pretty nice. Let's look at that on the front end. In fact, this time we're actually gonna view the live page, so there we go. Looks good. Almost matches the FormRobin color here. So yeah, I approve. Oh, kind of cool here with the single page option. We can scroll through the different questions by just choosing the numbers. I like that. I haven't seen that before in other form builders. Even a kind of an interesting little animation effect here as the number slides in to replace the previous one. Either it comes from the left or the right. It doesn't seem to have a rhyme or a reason for which way it goes. Now, in terms of collecting your data after the fact, when someone fills out a form, you can get an email notification. It's on by default, so it's gonna go to your main email account. We can also redirect customers to a specific URL, so just toggle this on, enter in the page you want them to go to, and then they'll be sent there for like a thank you, welcome message, or whatever is next in your flow. Some administration slash organization stuff. If we're on the back end here under our forms, we can organize things into folders. So I've just got my folder here that I've called demo, but it's very easy to add a new folder here or rename an existing one. Just hit edit and you can give it a name right there. And then you've got your most recent forms up top. Now this is the form that we created together and it's titled &MBSP because remember I titled it space. So that's what it looks like in HTML. I've got some options over here for viewing the sessions. So people that actually have recorded answers in the form that will show up here. There are some analytics in terms of total views, number of submissions, and the conversion rate. And a really nice touch, you can actually see where people dropped off in terms of what question they viewed before they left your form entirely. There are no custom domains on FormRobin, so when you share a URL, you're gonna be sharing a FormRobin URL, but you can embed the forms on your own website. So again, a little bit of a workaround here where you can just embed the embed code, put it on a page on your website, and then it will have your URL as you share it. And to answer my own question from before regarding the styling of forms, remember there's no custom themes, but you could set up kind of a default template type of form and then just go in here and duplicate it in order to keep all of the colors exactly the same. Now, the deal page on AppSumo says that it comes with 3 workspaces, and honestly, I'm trying to figure out what that means exactly. I thought maybe they mean folders so that you can organize things. It would be a little bit of a strange restriction to limit you to just 3 folders, and indeed, it is a strange restriction. I've created 4 folders here. There doesn't seem to be any limit on that. However, I don't see anywhere in the interface where I could create a new workspace to keep things separate from my first form. So, yeah, a really interesting thing. Maybe it's a feature that's coming that's just not there yet. All right, we still have not tried the most important feature here, which is to generate a form with AI. And I'm gonna do that in a second, but first I wanna just show you some of the options you have after your forms are submitted. How do you get this data out of FormRobin and into your actual workflow? There's not a ton of integrations here, but I feel like the ones that they have started with are very high quality ones and probably very useful to a lot of people. We've got settings, integrations. Zapier is the top one. There's also SendFox. So if you're using another AppSumo original, SendFox, you'll be able to add form respondents right to your mailing list. And then there is Google Sheets. So you can do a lot of automations getting your data into Google Sheets. Really easy to connect up to N8N or any automation platform you're currently using. There's also webhooks. So if you want a webhook to receive notifications for a form submission, you can definitely do that. Again, makes integrating with automation platforms a lot easier. And if you're curious, the webhook payload is going to include all field responses. So it'll be very easy to take this data and use it inside of an automation and even pair it up with an AI agent if you so please. There's also an integration with the Metapixel, so you can retarget and send ads to people who have viewed your forms, and there is an API, so if you want to build your own connections, you can do that too. And hey, they've even got API documentation, which not everybody does that has APIs, so I'm happy to see that. All right, little bug here on the dashboard I'll just call out. It's kind of what I do on this channel is nitpick, but I've created 4 forms at this point, and it's still telling me no recent activity, and my top forms are no forms created yet. So it would seem that 4 forms and no forms, those are conflicting pieces of information. I'm just curious where the button's gonna go after I've already got information on this field. So I'd like to see what that looks like. I'm wondering if logging out and logging back in is going to do it. And let's go to the dashboard here. No, it doesn't. So it just added a new form for me. I had 4 when I logged out and now I've got 5. Very interesting. But let's go ahead and fill out a form and just see if that fills up the dashboard. I'm gonna clear out some of these blank forms. I think they were created when I made the new folders. Like I just put a form in each one of them. Trying out my form here, I'm on the Wistia question and I do get the conditional logic, so that's cool. All right, I've submitted my form. I'm gonna go back to the dashboard. And now it is populated. So it will remain blank until someone has actually filled out a form. Very interesting. Now, if I wanted to create a new form, I guess I have to go to the forms section over here. They should add a button on this screen to create forms as well, but not that hard to click in and then choose new form. And we are finally going to try out this AI form generation. For my prompt, I said, create a questionnaire for applicants to a WordPress management business looking to be hired as a support agent. Ask general info questions as well as challenging questions that would help weed out inexperienced candidates. So this is a pretty beefy prompt. I feel like that's a difficult task. The AI is thinking, let's see how it does. All right, there we go. I got my form back and pretty quickly, I might add. It looks very good. There's a lot of questions here. I've already kind of scanned through it. As you can see, there's lots and lots of questions. Overall, the quality of the questions is very good. A lot of things I might not have thought to ask, and it would definitely save me some time having to go out and research what other people are asking and then rebuild it myself. There are a couple areas where I think the AI could improve. First of all, there's a few instances where it did these checkbox answers and it just didn't give any answers available. It just has blank option and only one of them. So you have to make sure you don't overlook that and fill those out. Now, you do want to proofread these or check through to make sure all of the questions are what you want. It's not quite that good yet. The other feedback I would say is that the organization of the form is a little bit all over the place. So it starts off, as you might expect, with the personal information. That's good. But then it starts to get into some more technical things before going back to more personal information. So I'd like that just organized a little bit better, maybe with some headlines. There is actually a way to just add in text inside of FormRobin. I didn't show you this earlier, but I can go ahead and choose new question and then just add in a statement here. And this is where I can just organize my questionnaire into different sections. So I could say like work history and make this a title and have it be italic or whatever you want to do. That is a great option to have, and I would love if the AI implemented that so the form felt a little bit more cohesive. It would also be great to have page breaks. For a long form like this, I might like to have a multiple step form. So currently we've just got everything all in one page, or having it single question at a time. Being able to group it together and add in page breaks would be really cool. So for $19, I do think that FormRobin is an excellent way to collect data from potential customers or even your existing customers. I think there's a lot of features that could be added in that would provide a lot more value and make this ultra competitive with some of the other more expensive form builders out there. And I actually have pretty good faith that AppSumo will add in a large degree of the features that I've thought of. I'm sure they already thought of them as well. Over time, they do tend to improve their products pretty significantly, but they kind of do it under the radar. They just add in features here and there until it's like, wow, this is actually a very compelling product. As it is right now, I think the two main things that will irritate many AppSumo customers is the branding as well as the lack of white labelability in terms of you can't add your own CNAME redirect to have your own custom domain name. You have to rely on those embeds. But for $19, you can hardly complain. I'm gonna go ahead and rate this one a 7.1 out of 10. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit that like button. If you're not already subscribed, I encourage you to do so. My name is Dave. I'll be hanging around in the comments. If you've got any feedback for me, any questions about FormRobin or anything else on AppSumo, definitely hit me up. I'll be back soon with more videos. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next one.